Okay, the next thing we're going to do is add, let's replace our dictionary cache in ASCII-chan with Memcached. Okay, here we are in ASCII-chan. Fortunately, Memcached is, there's a version built into the App Engine that you run on your local machine, so you can develop against it. And then when you deploy your machine on App Engine, Google has Memcached already spread out for you across many machines, and you don't have to deal with it. So that's a very nice convenience. First, what we do is we import it, which is just, it's in the Google App Engine API Memcached. So we do that. And now let's replace our dictionary cache with Memcached, which should be pretty straightforward since the two behave very similarly. OK, the first thing we can get rid of is this cache line. We don't need that anymore. So we got rid of our cache dictionary. Let's use the Memcached library now. Now, this syntax here, key in cache, and all of this stuff is specific to Python dictionaries. So we need to get rid of that. Instead, let's try to look the arts up out of Memcached. So it's going to be arts equals memcached.get key. Now, in Memcached, in the official protocol, both keys and values need to be strings. In this library, values can be Python data types, and the Memcached library that Google provides will convert your Python data type into a string. And then when you fetch the data out of the cache, it'll convert it back into your Python data type. So we can still store our art objects directly in the cache, but the keys need to be strings. And so we're going to use top as our key. Now we're going to change this if statement a little bit, because now we just looked up arts out of a Memcache. And if it's not in the cache, arts will be none. So let's structure this like so. If arts is none or update, run the query. And we don't need that other line. Now, so the query doesn't change. We need to change this line to set the key in the cache, which is this memcache.set key arts. And that should do it. OK, so let's go ahead and try this out on our browser. We're in our page now. If I reload this page, we can go to our terminal. And we can see that we ran a DB query on our GET request. And if we were to run another, if we were to reload that page again, I reloaded it, you would see that we don't do a DB query. Pretty cool, huh? I'd like to show you something. Built in the App Engine is an admin tool. If you're running App Engine, you can go to /ah/admin/memcached, and you can actually view the memcache thing. And if I reload this page, it says that we have one item in our cache. And if I were to click flush cache, we can actually clear the cache. And if I were to reload this page and then check out our console, we can see that we ran a database query again. And if I go back to our page here and reload it, we can see that we have one item in our cache because we just loaded it. This is kind of neat. You can type in a key here and click display, and it'll show you the value in that cache. And in this case, it says top is pickled. Pickled is the Python library for converting a Python object into a string. And the Google Memcached library is automatically doing that for us. So yeah, pretty neat, handy tool here. If you want to test your caching, you can sit here and flush it, and you can see how many items are in the cache and manipulate it that way. So anyway, that's how you implement add Memcached to your app. Once you understand the algorithm for caching, you know, check the cache, return the value, hit the DB, that sort of thing, using Memcached is a cinch.